One extremely useful tool that you'll use if you do any amount of development against Data Hub is the API console. If I go to Developer Tools and select API console, we can view it now. If you're familiar with tools like Postman or Insomnia, you'll feel right at home here at the API console. Like those tools, it'll allow you to make REST API calls against our API, but in this case, you don't have to worry about authentication since we just use your session token. To start off with, I'll just show you an example of making a GET request against our namespaces route. So if I do that, we can see that I have a list of namespaces within this tenant. If I want to dig deeper and take a look at some of the streams within this namespace, I could do so by just adding a slash, and we can see that some recommendations for the different namespaces show. I'm going to stick with the AVEVA events. I'm going to go to the streams route, and then I'm going to select my stream. And I'll just pick one of these and go to the streams data route. And we can see that I have a bunch of options that I can use to query data against this stream. For example, I could provide a start index and an end index if I want to do a window data call, or if I just want to get the last value. Just do slash last and retrieve that data value. If I'm happy with this call, I can always save it for later by adding it to my favorites. So I'll click the add to favorites button. And whenever I click this, it'll bring me back to this request. I can also go back to requests made previously in the session by clicking the session request history and selecting one of the requests. So far, we've just been looking at the GET verb, but we also have the option to use post, put, delete, or patch. To show an example of post, let's go back to streams. And we'll change the verb from GET to post. And as we can see, the request format has changed where I now have a body that I can include. If I'm not quite sure what to include in that body, I can click this Insert Stream Template button, which will fill out the basic body that would be required to create a stream. And I could go through and fill out this information like the type ID, the name, and the description. And once I hit post, a new stream will have been created. If I need to access a different version of the API than version 1, at the top left, I can change the target API version and say go to V1 preview. This will give me access to preview features or to other features that are available in different API versions. Something else that you may have noticed is that all of the requests that have been made so far are scoped at the tenant level. If instead I want to make a request at the account level, I can click this home button, which will truncate that full path. And I can add to the URI as before, but this time at the account level, so I now have access to communities and other features. An excellent way to get started with programming against our Data Hub APIs is to utilize the samples we have available in our OSIsoft GitHub organization. Under our OSI samples ADH hub article, we have a list of different samples that meet different categories. Some really common ones to use when you're just getting started are these authentication samples. And you can see that we have a variety of different OAuth flows, including client credentials, hybrid flow, an authorization code supporting different languages. If I select one of these samples, we could see that it has a README, which lists the requirements along with how to set up the sample. And for most of the samples in our GitHub organization, the secrets are stored within our app settings file. And for this, you'll just put your connection information, such as your resource, your API version, your tenant ID, your client ID, and client secret. And this information can all be found within the Data Hub portal, which I'll quickly show. Okay, so I'm back in Data Hub, and if we want to get that connection information, we could do so by going to security and clients, And if I select one of these clients, we can go all the way to the top right and click connection information, where we'll see our tenant ID, our region endpoints, along with the namespaces available within our tenants. And I can get my client ID from details, and I can generate a secret under secrets.